They let me back into the hospital. Who could that be on the phone? Some joker stuck the damn mosquito. There was no one there. Maybe it was all in my head. I think I need some pills. Which one should I go for today? I think I'm going to just eat an entire pencil case. Let's see, shall we? Diazepam. Yes, diazepam. That seems like just the ticket to get me through some routine heart surgery. Let's see how we do, shall we? You see, I've been reading some books. I've been reading some books on how to perform heart surgery on lovely sleeping patients. You look after my watch there, you handsome man. Now, let's just take the blanket off. There we go. They let me back into the hospital. They took away my license, but they let me back into the hospital. They thought... they thought I could be trusted. Well, that's how much I can be trusted. Oh, I got an achievement for that. Let's work our way around the ribcage. Yes, I think we'll have some orange pop. Oh, the bottle appears to be empty. Let's instead then, let's go for the bone saw. Yes. No, he's not waking up, is he? Fuzzy shave, Van Gogh. Let's just cut this nasty little rib cage out, shall we? Oh, indeed, cut him open. Well, no, that's not what I meant to do. You've taken my bone saw now. That makes me very unhappy. Right. It's difficult to saw when you're using the wrong damn side of the saw. Okay, well, let's dispense with this instrument then. We'll go with the fun bone saw instead. Come on, cut through, there you are. Right. Oh, what a fool I was when I first started my internship to start hacking away at rib cages from the middle. Always work from the outside. Makes the removal of the rest of the rib cage that much easier. Now it's stuck! On before anyone else comes in, need to cut this ribcage out. And are we getting anywhere? We just need to be making him lose blood. Oh, that will have to do. There we are. Just one more on this side. That's the ticket. I think I just dismembered a oh dear, he seems to be losing blood now. At a somewhat prolific rate. Well, that's not what we want. It means the life support machine will go off and people might find us and see what we're doing. And now I keep getting my tools lodged. There we go. And now we'll get rid of this rib cage. And now where to go from here? Well, at the rate of his blood loss, I'm not sure we can do much. Get rid of this! Okay, just one more lung to move out. I can hear people at the doors. I can hear people are trying to come in and save him. But they're not going to save him because they won't find his lung after I reach in it.
Now, this is the way you perform a routine heart transplant. This is our second patient of the day. Unfortunately, the last one was... well... shall we say, troubled by an escaped mental patient. Now, when I perform heart surgery, I like to go in with the power drill, firstly. You see, as well as my being a fan of DIY around the home, I'm also a fan of DIY around the human body. It's one of the jokes I like to tell the medical students, you see. Because I find there's nothing better to use than a hammer, a power drill, the occasional chisel, wallpaper scraper, maybe the odd paintbrush, and... there we go. As you can see, by removing the ribcage from the outside and working in, it means there's less mess for us to... debris, as we like to call it in the medical profession, to worry about. Nope, man, oh dear. Don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, that happens from time to time. Occasionally the drill slipped, and you end up impaling the patient. But don't worry, he's on all the machines, including the one that goes bing, that make sure he's perfectly safe. Now let's put this somewhere safe. That looks like it'll do it. So if we remove the rib cage now, and again put it someplace safe. There we go, we'll prop it up there for now. Now, he's on a respirator, which means he doesn't need these pesky lungs that will just get in the way of the heart surgery. So, my suggestion to you, interns, is that you just pull it out deftly. You just have to use a bit of wrist action. That's it. Push and pull. There we go. Out it comes, out it comes. Oh, and you might lose the liver around this point. But not to worry. Oh, good job I lost my wristwatch there, and not somewhere more important. And there, the other ones just pop out like so, because the lungs are barely attached to the human body. Now, this leaves us with the troubling nature that is the esophagus. So, we need to find something to cut through the esophagus, something gentle. I like to use a scalpel. Now, we have various scalpels, and I have to be honest, I sometimes forget which one works best on which organ. Oh, but that one did... that one did do the job. But, you know, I think we need another one to cut it off at the root. Although, you never know, I might be able to pull the stomach out. No, it's still attached, damn thing. Stomachs are like that, you see. They have a nasty way of just clinging on. So that's why we're going to go with another scalpel, if I can just... I'm sorry, at lunch I was having a drink with some of the other consultants, and my grip is on reality, and surgery is less than it perhaps should be. So we just make a neat little incision around by the stomach. That's it. Almost like that. Come on. Cut through, you little shit. There we are. As you can see, the stomach just plops off. Not a reason to worry at all. Oh, and I nearly got the other tool back, but don't worry, we'll get the nurses to plunge their hands into the back of the arm to get that little tool. So, right now we've got an esophagus in the way. That's the esophagus, yes, that's what feeds your stomach from the throat. Well, from the mouth. If you've got food going down your throat, you are in a whole other heap of trouble, I can tell you. I don't need to be a doctor to tell you that. I am, however, a doctor. And, let me see, I'm terribly sorry, my hand is still a bit palsied from the drink. We'll just drop the esophagus over there, he doesn't need it anymore. The stomach, I think, can sit where it is. It's not doing anyone any harm. Now we just need to cut the heart out. Now, some people favour using clamps at this point. I, however, think, well, and I was always taught, that's the pussy's way of doing things. I was taught in a military hospital, you see. And there we go. You just make one neat incision there, and another one. Nope. Silly me. Sometimes I forget myself.
There we are. And just like that, the heart comes out. And as you can see, he's surprisingly not losing any blood, because he is our first Cyberman. Now, I just need to get rid of that heart. There we go. I'll find a nice home for this. In this tray. Oh, and he's lost his ribcage. That's alright, we'll make one out of fiberglass for him. Now, we've got his new heart, which, as you'll see, if plopped into the chest cavity... If plopped into the chest cavity... is not happy yet. No. Because we need to remove all the instruments debris from him first. Or I pray to God we don't have to stitch him up. That's what I would hire a nurse to do. I mean, I'm not some bloody... What am I pulling on here? Well, this is a bit dash awkward. I think I might need to get one of the powerful tools again to dislodge something. Let's go for this little fellow here, yes. So, if nothing else, I might be able to move the stomach out of the way. And make it easier for me to pick it up. There we go, and we'll put the syringe back down. And now, as you can see, I somehow completed the surgery with an A rating. That is all it takes. It really is more simple than it looks. Well, thank you very much for attending the lecture, my students. If you do have any questions, please pop them in on a postcard. Can you believe it? I actually performed heart surgery. And that was for all the naysayers out there. Now, I may be able to perform heart surgery, but I still can't get a floppy disk in a machine. Britannia 88 disk. Minigame? I sure as shit hope so. You think Lord Britain's on it? Oh, that fucking phone! Well, I thank you very much for watching. I don't think we're ever going to find out what Britannia 88 is, despite the fact I'm very interested in it. No, that's the wrong thing. But I'm going to give it my best shot by stroking the floppy disk. Struggling to clench my fist. I will get you in there, you bastard. Oh, you know what? All right. Yeah, oh, I can't even do that right. Ooh.